And now from our studios in downtown Winnipeg, it's time for 107 Live.
Good morning and welcome. You're listening to Morning Light, and now it's time for 107 Live. I've got a couple guests in the studio, two guitarists, recent graduates from University of Manitoba, members of the Winnipeg Classical Guitar Society. I have Nick Miller and Alex Tyboroski in to perform duets. They're going to be performing on January 30th as part of an evening called Frets Alive, along with a number of other guitarists. So I welcome them both into the studio this morning. Good morning, Nick.
Good morning.
Good morning, Alex. Thank you guys for coming in this morning. And so what are you going to hit us with right off the top?
We're going to do the first number one tango from the Astor Piazzolla's Tango Suite.
Okay, let's have a listen to it. Thank you. Love the music of Astor Piazzolla. Excellent. It's a beautiful piece. I have in the studio with me Nick Miller and Alex Tyboroski. They're a guitar duet, and they'll be performing January 30th as part of Frets Alive. I'll tell you about ticket information, but let's have a little chat with them first. Let's swing the microphone over to Nick on the left-hand side there. Here we go. So, Nick, when did you start playing the guitar?
I started when I was about 6 or 7 years old, but I would say not seriously until I was in my early teens. That's when I finally met the right instructor who kind of led me in the right direction. That was Skender Seffa.
Skender, yes.
Yeah.
So when you met him, how did you know he was the right teacher for you?
I guess you can just kind of feel it at first. He kind of liked the same music I liked in my rebellious teen years and kind of introduced me to classical at the same time.
So when you say your rebellious teen years, was it more like heavy metal you listened to or punk?
Yeah, I think we all have a little heavy metal in us.
So when you started playing the guitar, was it the first instrument that you picked up, or did you start with other instruments? Piano
before
that?
It was, actually. I do kind of wish I took up piano first. I'm trying now to kind of pick up the piano, and it's difficult being two hands and 10 fingers opposed to just 4 on the guitar.
Mm-hmm. So when do you have time to do the piano when you're studying the guitar and playing the guitar full time?
Lately, not very much, to be honest.
So you recently graduated from University of Manitoba, their music school there.
Mm-hmm.
Who are some of your teachers at U of M?
I actually studied under his dad, Richard Tyboroski.
Uh-huh.
And that was the primary guitar instructor.
Yeah. So growing up, who are some of your influences, musical influences on the guitar? Other than, you know, even your rebellious age, who did you like in the rock bands?
As we discussed earlier, I actually fell in love with the piece Koi and Baba that we talked about.
Oh yeah, off air we were talking about Koi and Baba.
Landa Asturias was kind of one of those pieces I just had to learn. Just kind of see someone play it and then you just kind of have to replicate it after.
Mm-hmm. So let's swing the microphone over to Alex.
Hello.
Thank you. Hello. Bring it a little bit closer so we can hear. Okay. And what about you? I guess you've grown up with guitar in your family, your father being a guitarist.
I was kind of forced into playing guitar. At the young age of 6 or 7 or so.
Okay.
Yeah, so.
What would you have rather been doing?
I don't know.
Out playing with friends,
video games, going outside, hanging out there.
No regrets now, though, probably.
No, yeah, it was definitely worth it for sure.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So, what was it like growing up with a father that played guitar, and was he probably your first and biggest influencer?
I mean, I couldn't really go outside without like having a lesson or practicing. He always made sure I practiced a lot, which helped a lot later on. Going to a lot of Guitar Society concerts, of course. I had a lot of master classes when I was younger, so I've been playing for a really long time. Just a lot of exposure to a lot of high class acts, I guess you could say,
and
a lot of different music.
Was it always classical guitar, classical music, or
that he would show me? Probably, yeah. I remember like a Paul McCartney CD when I was really young, and I know my dad really likes the Beatles, but I never really got into the Beatles.
Mm-hmm.
All like the metal and stuff he was talking about. My dad never liked that at all, so I was really into that, though.
So what about in terms of music? Was there a particular artist or composer that you first heard that sort of really turned your mind around about the guitar?
For classical, it was probably Roland Dion's. I think a lot of people have him as a big influence. Pieces like Tango in Sky, Fuoco, a lot of his like jazzy stuff I was really into. I would say he was probably like the number one guy that got me into classical guitar.
So you guys both just recently graduated from University of Manitoba. You're part of the Winnipeg Classical Guitar Society. What is belonging to the Winnipeg Classical Guitar Society, being hooked up with them? What does that do for you guys? How does that help you out?
Well, I guess you don't have to pay as much for concerts. That helps.
It's always a bonus, yeah.
It allows us to play every year as well.
Yeah. With different concerts, so like the Frets Alive, I guess, part of the Frets Alive concert.
Yeah, exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's just, I mean, we've been playing with them. I've been playing with them for a long time. I've gotten to see lots of master classes, a lot of good performances. Mm-hmm. I mean,
any highlights from the last couple of years?
Last couple of years. Well, we were talking about Thibaut earlier.
Thibaut Covin.
Yeah. That was probably the best one from last year.
Mm-hmm.
Guys that I got to see Roland Dions, that was many years ago. I had a master class with him. That was pretty huge. I mean, there's always a lot of good
Most performers that come through, world-class performers coming through.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So you guys are performing on January 30th. You're doing a duo with, there's also Nolan Powell, James Graham, Braden Olson are also performing. And are you going to be doing that Piazzolla piece?
Yes, we'll also be doing the third, number three.
The tangos.
Yeah.
Okay, so what are we going to hear from you now?
Now you're going to hear Sakura no Hana variations. It's an old Japanese melody from, I think, the Edo period. So it's very ancient when the samurais were around.
Mm-hmm.
It's just a very modern take on the theme. There is a solo variation, but I don't think it's as interesting at all. This one is a lot more modern, and of course you can do a lot more things with two guitars. Also, the composer, I think, adds a lot of innovative techniques to the guitar, and you'll see a few of them in this one. His name's Marek Pachesny. He's mm-hmm. a Polish guy, like me.
Okay, well, let's have a listen to it.
Okay.
Duo guitar, we've got Alex Miller, and we have Nick Miller and Alex Tyboroski. Thank you. Fabulous. Wow. Never heard a version of that. I've heard that piece played many times before, but never for a guitar duo. Beautiful Sakura. And thank you, guys. That's really wonderful rendition of that work.
Thanks for having us.
Nick Miller, we have here. We have Alex Tyboroski as well. And they're going to be performing January 30th as part of Frets Alive with Winnipeg Classical Guitar Society. And you can go to winnipegclassicalguitarsociety.com for more information. Tickets are available at the door. Again, January 30th, 8 p.m. And Eckhard Gramate Hall is where they'll be performing. Thank you guys for coming in, and we'll have you back again.
Thank you.
Thanks.
From our studios in downtown Winnipeg, you've been listening to 107 Live, Classic 107's Intimate Concert Series, the soundtrack for your life.